Hey everybody, this is Sean Pitcher, your local dietitian out of Atlanta, coming at you with another snack recipe that you can throw together within 5-10 minutes or less. We're going to be making a chia pudding today. Again, there's a lot of different things you can stick in, you can stick on your chia pudding. We're going to make a just basic chia pudding, and I'll talk about some different options you can either put inside it or you can put on top of it once it's completely done. So we're going to kind of go ingredient by ingredient. First thing you're going to need is your chia seeds. All right, you can get these pretty much at any local store. I typically shop at Aldi's. We're gonna be making a double batch today, so I'm gonna be calling out some of the measuring amounts. We're gonna be doubling these. So I have a quarter cup of chia seeds. So that's one quarter, and I'm going to be doing two of those today. All right, chia seeds are a great source of plant-based protein, fiber, and also healthy fats. What basically makes this pudding gel together is the chia seeds. So if you've ever had a chia seed in your mouth, or if you've ever had it sit on water, basically what it does is the chia seed gels up. So whatever liquids and things that we pour into the bowl here with the chia seeds, and we have them sit overnight, it's going to gel and soak up a lot of those liquids, which is gonna solidify the pudding essentially. So chia seeds are done. Next thing I have is a quarter cup of yogurt. Great way to add some probiotics, which is good for your gut health. And then two, that's gonna add a little bit extra protein in there as well. Got a little bit on your finger. Give it a taste. Vanilla, tastes pretty good. We have our pure vanilla extract. If you wanna up the ante, you can get yourself some real vanilla bean, or you can shave it off with a knife and put them in there. That will definitely enhance the flavor much more than getting the vanilla extract in a bottle, but that's what we have, so that's what we're gonna use. And I have 1 teaspoon. Since we're doubling the dose, we will be doing 2 teaspoons of vanilla today. Next we have is our sweetener. So sweetener, you could use honey, agave. I'm gonna be using some maple syrup to give this a little bit of sweetness. And this will be 2 tablespoons. So 1 dollop there, and then a second dollop. Sometimes with some of our stickier ingredients, I'll let that tablespoon sit in there so everything kind of runs off of the spoon. Next, we're gonna need our liquid, which is gonna help as we mix all the chia seeds and other ingredients in with that. That liquid's gonna get soaked up by the chia seeds to help essentially create our pudding. All of that maple syrup is gone and out of our spoon, so we're gonna take that spoon out, put that in the sink, and then we're gonna place our 2 cups of milk into here. Now, if you want this to be a very creamy chia pudding, right, using a whole or 2% milk is probably gonna be a better option. If you want it really creamy, you can actually use cream. You know, if you look at milks, whole milk, 2%, 1% milk, right? This is 130 calories per serving, whole is 150, 1% is probably 110. Not really a huge calorie difference, if you ask me. I'd rather have it taste good and eat a couple extra calories. Not really a huge deal. And then we have our second cup of milk. Now, a couple different things you can do here. If you want to up the amount of protein, you can do more Greek yogurt. I have some Muscle Melt protein powder here. Whether it's chocolate, vanilla, strawberry, cookies and cream, you can essentially change the flavor of what the pudding tastes like, and add some extra high quality protein in with the protein powder if you want to. If you don't like protein powder, you can obviously increase it with more Greek yogurt. The other thing you could do too as well is if you want to cut up some type of berries, or it's blueberries, blackberries, cherries, raspberries, strawberries, banana, you could do that as well. Or you could do sliced banana, melt some peanut butter in the microwave for about 30 seconds, and then you could also layer the peanut butter in there and almost have like a peanut butter banana chia pudding. Again, this is essentially a blank template, and you can then do really whatever you want with it. I'm not gonna stick any fruit in here today like I talked about earlier. I'll wait once this is cooled and gelled and all good to go. And I'm honestly gonna stick my fruit on top, almost like an acai bowl. So you know when your acai bowl, you kind of get that thick blended fruit consistency. And some of these places you might go, they'll layer fruits on it, they'll layer nuts on it, dried fruits, different types of seeds, trail mixes, granola, things like that. You can do essentially the same exact thing with your chia seed pudding if you want to. It's just a different texture, a different concept. So I have my whisk here. Just gonna have this at a slight angle. And I'm going to mix my ingredients up so they're thoroughly mixed together. Now, obviously in this video, you are not going to be seeing the final product, but it will look like a thickened version of what I will bring up to the screen. Okay, so there is our chia pudding. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a piece of saran wrap over top. I'm gonna go put it in the refrigerator. It's gonna sit in there overnight. Again, like I said, that those chia seeds are gonna gel up and they're gonna make that kind of thick pudding-y consistency that we're looking for. And then it'll be ready to go. Something really great as a snack perspective that you can have in between breakfast and lunch, lunch and dinner, or you can have it as a PM snack. Again, really rich in protein, fiber, healthy fats. And again, there's lots of different ways where I said you could add healthy fats, you can add different fruits to it, you can add our healthy fats with some different nuts, different seeds, trail mix, stuff like that. So there's lots of ways you can kind of mix and match and make this however you'd like to. Hope you're able to try this in your own kitchen sometime today or maybe this week, and it provides you another option because variety is key. The more variety we have, the better we're able to stay consistent with our meals, our snacks, and our eating behaviors and patterns throughout the week. If you want to watch more videos like this, if you want to watch videos on sports nutrition tips, exercise technique, or strength and conditioning, go ahead and go to my Instagram, overtime_Sean, and you will find all my digital links on my link tree where you can look up all that different information and provide you lots of things you can learn and help develop your own tools. So I hope you guys enjoyed.